Hello, hello, mic test. It looks like a very good strategy. The net profit is 1000 plus percent. The percent profitability is more than 70%, which is good. But the best thing in this entire strategy is that the average trade is around 2%. It means that we are making around 2% in every trade, which makes it a very good strategy. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to create the best pullback trading strategy in Pine Script, then you are at the right place. This is the fourth video of our playlist. In the first three videos, we explored tilted RSI, which is an upgraded version of RSI divergence. The second one was drift Bollinger Band strategy. The third one was the grid trading bot. And the fourth one, this one, which is the best pullback strategy that we are about to create. If you guys are new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel I upload videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, some highly valuable finance APIs, and making trading strategies on Pine Script like this one. And if there's something that you are interested in, then you should subscribe to my YouTube channel and also hit on the bell icon, because there is a lot of content that I'm about to share on this particular YouTube channel, especially in the Pine Script trading strategy side. So if you don't want to miss out on those future content, then you should stay tuned to my YouTube channel. So the topics that we are going to cover in this particular video is, in order to make the pullback trading strategy in Pine Script, we'll first understand what is pullback strategy. Then we will make some logics on moving average. Then we'll create some entry and close conditions in the Pine Script. We'll plot some of the graphs on the main chart that we have, that would be having on the trading view. And lastly, we would explore something which will make this pullback strategy even better. That is exploring too deep and too thin trading logics. What are those things? I will explain each and everything while writing the code itself. So let's start. So if you Google what is pullback strategy, basically it's a trading strategy where we try to buy a stock or commodity or any security, crypto for example, when the price has dipped temporarily, and then we try to pick the temporary upward and downward movement, right? So we are not chasing the trend. So for example, in this particular graph, it's clearly explained the trend is on a bullish side, but here what we will be doing is we will be placing a sell order here and a buy order here, another sell order here, another buy order here, and so on. So we're just trying to pick small segments of this particular uptrend such that we try to maximize the profit as in this particular thing. Now this is definitely a bit risky trading strategy, because if this particular segment is not captured, then there is a very good possibility that you'll make losses. That's why we have to put a stop loss in this particular strategy. And again, a very important disclaimer, I'm not giving this strategy as an investment advice. This is just made for educational purpose. The main reason of this entire playlist is to give you education on how to make your own strategy. Perfect. So in order to capture these segments, we will actually be focusing on two different moving averages. The first moving average would be having a length of very I would say high number, somewhere around 300 or 200, and the another one would have a very small number, somewhere around 10 or 15, right? So in that case, we'll be capturing two different types of trends, right? So that's the main focus, and this is what we are going to do in the Pine Script. So let's start writing the code on Pine Script. I'll start with this thing, which is I'm doing everything on version 5 in Pine Script, right? Strategy is equal to best pullback trading strategy video, right? That's the title of this particular strategy. Overlay is equal to true because I want to plot everything on the main chart. If we don't keep it true, it will plot a separate chart, right? So I'm keeping it true. Initial capital is equal to 1000. Default quantity type is strategy dot percent of equity, and default quantity value is 100 because I want 100% of the amount to be trading in this particular strategy for all the trades, right? So now let's start with the inputs. The first one is MA length 1, the first moving average length. So input dot int, which is because it's an integer. Let's just provide a very high number, suppose say 280. Yeah, but before that, I'm doing everything, guys, on Bitcoin. It is BTC USD. If you click here, I've actually picked the first one itself. And the time interval that I'm considering for candlesticks is 3 hours, right? You can try it for different intervals as well. The title for this particular input is MA length 1. Step can be 10, right? And let's just group it. And the name of the group would be moving average parameters, right? And then in line is equal to MA, right? I want the first two lengths input to be in the same line, right? So that's the first input. Second one is MA length 2 is equal to, let's just copy and paste it here, right? And the length for this one is, say, very small number, which is, say, 13. It's MA length 2. Steps, let's do it 1. Moving average parameters the group, and this is perfect. Now, stop loss is very important in this strategy, as I mentioned. So input dot float, I have provided the title to be stop loss percent. Default value is, say, 7%. We can anyways change it in the input box. Step is equal to 0.1, and the group is exactly the same one, which is moving average parameters. I want it to be the same, to be a part of the same group itself. Now let's do the calculations. The first one is MA1, which is the moving average using the first MA length, right? I'll do it on close and MA length 1. Similar to this, I'll just copy and paste it here, change the MA1 to MA2 and this one to MA length 2, right? And that's it. Now let's write the entry and close conditions. Let me just zoom it a bit. I think this is better now. Okay, perfect. So entry and close conditions. Before that, let's provide a float variable, which is buy price is equal to 0. I'll tell you the reason. Basically, I am providing it to be 0 in the beginning, and then I'll change it in the condition. So this is how we can do it. So the first condition is a buy condition. But let's do one thing. Let's just plot both the moving averages for a better understanding. So plot moving average 1 and plot moving average 2. When I save it, it will ask me to give the script name. So save it and then put it on chart. Perfect. Of course, there are no trades because we are yet to write the logics for trades. So this is how the two moving averages look like, right? And the moving average with the higher length value represents the long-term trend, right? On the other hand, the smaller one represent the short-term trend. For example, in this case, you can see this is a short-term trend, right? And this is a very good example, actually, in this case. If you see from this point to this point, the short-term trend is negative, but the long-term trend is positive. So we are just trying to pick these small movements so that we make some profit in this particular area, right? So the main idea here is that for buy condition, the close price should be greater than the moving average 1 and it should be less than the moving average 2. Suppose in this case, this point, right? So this particular price is, let me just zoom it a bit, right? I think that's good. So in this particular area, this price is greater than moving average 1, but it's less than moving average 2. So we can get a buy position here. So basically it will go up, right? And then will go down eventually. So we will make a buy position here and then we'll try to exit it here. If we are able to do this, then we have a successful strategy. That's the main idea. I'll repeat, the close price should be more than moving average 1 and it should be less than the moving average 2. So let's come back to our code. Let's write the logic here. So the close should be greater than MA1 and the close should be less than MA2. Simple logic. And one more thing, which is strategy dot position size should be equal to 0. Then only it will take the buy position. If there is already a buy position open, then in that case we will not make any more buy condition. Similar to this, the close condition would be, we will be focusing on this particular situation. So the close price should be greater than the moving average 2. In that case, we'll be closing. So in this particular situation, we'll be buying here and selling here, right? So we'll buy when the price is less than the moving average 2, and we'll sell when the price is more than the moving average 2. So basically, close is greater than MA2. That's it. And also, let's do one thing, which is strategy dot position size is greater than 0. Also, I want to include one more condition here, which is over here as well. It will not sell right away when it goes above the moving average 2 line. It will wait till the position where the close price is less than the low of the last candle, right? Let's do this thing. So let me just zoom it a bit. So in this case, it will buy it somewhere here and it will sell it somewhere here if we just provide that this condition, which is the close price should be greater than MA2, right? But I don't want to close it here. I want to close it somewhere here. So basically in this case, it will just see if the close price, for example, in this case, if the close price is less than the low of the last candle, then in that case, we can actually capture even a better movement. So for example, let's just see in this one, it will buy it somewhere here, right? I don't want to close up my trade here. I want to wait till the price, the close price is less than the low of the last candle. In this case, the low is here. And then I think this is the candle where it will close. So the low of the last candle was here, right? This green one. Let me just zoom it a bit more. So low of last candle was somewhere here. And the close of this candle is here, right? So it's less than the last candle low. So we'll sell it here. I want to sell it here, not here, such that we milk out some extra return out of this particular candle. So there's another condition that I'm providing here. So I'll just write and close should be less than low, not location, low and then one. That's simple. Now stop distance is equal to strategy dot position size is greater than zero. And then in that case, we'll just check if the buy price percentage difference from the closing price. So if the strategy dot position size is greater than zero, then we'll just see what's the percent difference between the buy price and the close, right? I just want to focus on the stop loss situation, right? So if this is greater than the stop loss that we provided in the inputs, then we have to close our position as well. So the close condition two, I should provide it close condition one, and this one is close condition two. A simple, which is strategy dot position size is zero, and stop distance, which is this one, is greater than stop loss. We have to stop it at that moment of time. Lastly, the stop price, if we want to calculate that, can be basically it's the same thing, which is strategy dot position size is greater than zero. And sorry, not and, if this is zero, then in that case, the stop price is buy price minus buy price multiplied by stop loss, which is basic stop loss calculation. Otherwise, if this condition is not getting met, then it's NA. Now the entry and the close condition, orders. Before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Guys, recently I launched my course on Python for Financial Programming with an Academy, and the link is in the description box, which is fpritvik.com/python. You can click in any one of these buttons depending on your location. And if you click on this, you'll see the entire course information over there. So basically, it's made for people who want to learn Python for financial programming from the very basics, right? From the scratch. And you can see that these are the main pointers. There are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes, 3 real world assignments, and 2 live projects in this particular course. These are the 2 live projects that I covered in this course. And this is the entire curriculum or the syllabus of this course. So I highly recommend for all the people who are struggling learning Python from scratch. I highly recommend this particular course to those guys. And if you use this code, which is RTK40, while enrolling, then you'll get a straight 40% discount. But this particular code is valid for a very limited time period, so please check it out, and I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code. So if buy condition, let me just do one thing, I should actually put it in the full screen. Okay, if buy condition, then strategy dot entry, I'll just write long, direction is strategy dot long, and yeah, that's it. Secondly, if buy condition, if there was a long position that was taken in the last candle, then I should change my buy price. That's the reason actually I introduced this buy price here, and then I was using it here. So I should change it to the new one, which is open. All the trades are triggered at the open price. Lastly, if close condition one and close condition two, actually it should be or close condition two, and strategy dot close, ID is long, comment is, let's just write exit plus close condition two, and then I just want to see if the second condition is getting met. Like for example, in this case, if are we hitting the stop loss, then if this is happening, then I'll just write SL is equal to true, otherwise I won't write anything here. And then we'll have to change the buy price again to NA. That's it. Now let's change the plot to, let's just provide some color here for the plots, which is, let's just pick blue for this one and orange for this one, for example. Save it and minimize this particular window. Okay, perfect. So we can see that there are many orders that are getting placed, and it looks great because I think we are getting long position here and closing here. That was the main motive as well. There are some incorrect trades here, but that's fine. I should be focusing on the bigger picture, which is looking great, but the exact picture will be clear in the strategy tester. Perfect. If we come here to the strategy tester, we can see there are 173 trades, 66.47% of percent profitability, 1.437 is the profit factor. Max drawdown is 27.75, which is not very good or not very bad. The average trade is amazing, which is 1.45%. That's great. And it actually looks very good. So in this case, if you see, there are some incorrect trades and I want to make them profitable. So basically, for example, in this case, what is happening? We are hitting a stop loss here. It got a long position here and then we are hitting a stop loss here. So actually what I've seen here is if the depth between these two moving averages is very high, then in that case, most of the trades are getting incorrect. For example, in this case, like you can see, it's very deep. Like this one is very low as compared to this orange line. And we had an open long position and then we hit the stop loss. Similar thing happened here as well. If you see, this is also a loss making trade. And also like here also the depth is very high, right? That's the first thing. The second thing that I realized is when the depth is very small. So let me just check it here, right? For example, in this case, the depth is high. Hardly anything, right? So our trade is also, I think, in loss or it makes hardly any profit. So I want to ignore these types of trades as well. So if the depth is very small, then I don't want to trade. If the depth is very high, then also I don't want to trade. So I will provide a couple of more conditions here in this case, which is the depth conditions. So yeah, I have actually provided these two. Sorry, let me just open this one. I have just provided these two additional inputs, float inputs, 2 deep % and 2 thin %. What is the definition of 2 deep and 2 thin? So if, for example, it's 27%, I would say difference between the MA1 and MA2, then it's 2 deep. If it's 3% or less, then it's 2 thin. Right? These are the two conditions. I will have to make some calculations here as well. So yeah, these are the calculations here. If the difference or if the percentage is percent difference of MA1 and MA2 is less than 2 deep, then only it will be considering trading. And for thin, if it's greater than 2 thin, then only it will consider. So I don't want to trade when it's 2 deep or 2 thin. And here on the buy condition, I'll just provide and 2 deep 2 and 2 thin 2. These are the two additional conditions, right? Now let's just save our code and let's see if there is any. Yeah, you can see all these trades are not happening now. So I think we should be getting some better trades. So yeah, it looks like a very good strategy. The net profit is 1,000+%. The total number of trades are also decent. The profit, the percent profitability is more than 70%, which is good. But the best thing in this entire strategy is that the average trade is around 2%. It means that we are making around 2% in every trade. This is an amazing thing. And I think, and personally speaking, this is the most important aspect for any trading strategy for me, at least. I don't consider the percent profitability to be the very, very important parameter. I think for me, it's this particular number is good. And for this strategy, we are hitting somewhere around 2%, which makes it a very good strategy. And definitely, it can be considered for further analysis to make our final trading strategy. Okay, guys, so I will save this particular code in my Google Drive. And not only this code, there are many more codes that are saved in that particular Google Drive that I've been maintaining since last 3 years. It includes things like my trading board and other study materials as well. So how to get the access of my Google Drive? But before that, guys, if you liked even one thing of this particular video, then just give me that like button, guys, because it's very, very important. And also write it in the comment section if you want me to cover in any particular trading strategy. And also if you try with some other inputs and you get even better results, then I would be really happy to know that as well. If you guys want me to involve in your personal projects, then you can reach out to me on this particular email address and I'll try my best to reach out to you as soon as possible. So in order to get the access of my Google Drive, just go to my YouTube channel and click on this access to my Google Drive button. Over there, you'll see some of the steps that you need to follow. And you can see that the cost of my Google Drive is a third of a coffee price. So it's very, very affordable. And I'm actually charging this small amount of money because I hired some intern to provide the best possible services to my Google Drive community members. In the next video, I'll be talking about super trend strategy. I am gonna explore something in Heikin-Ashi as well. So yes, please stay tuned. The video will be live on Saturday 3 p.m. India time. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And over there, you'll see this entire playlist on Pine Script trading strategies. And over there, you will see the most recent video that I uploaded. Down below, you can click on my website to explore a lot of things that I offer to my clients and my viewers. And I'll see you in the next video next Saturday with super trend strategy. And till then, peace.